Hi everyone, it's Earl. The demo you're about to watch is the demo that we showed off during the Xanadu episode of the TechNow webinar. I'll put that link in the description. That demo was recorded before early availability release for Xanadu, and things change quickly. This demo may look different than what you experience, but good news, we have product managers who want to show this off to you, and they will know all the details of what is coming. And good news, you can tune in live to Creator Toolbox tomorrow on this channel as the experts themselves, instead of me, demo it and answer your questions. I'll also add the link to that episode in the description once it airs. But in the meantime, enjoy this demo and we'll see you tomorrow on Creator Toolbox Live. Thanks, everyone. So I have two updates that I want to show you all today. It's going to be really fun. The first is the ServiceNow IDE. That's right, we have a full IDE now sitting inside of ServiceNow. This is Visual Studio Code implemented inside our ServiceNow instances that we know and love. And I'm gonna go ahead and demo it to you. I'm gonna go ahead and start by creating a new workspace. While I'm doing this, I'm also gonna show off the ServiceNow SDK version 2. But anyways, here's my new workspace. If you're familiar with GitHub or Visual Studio, this is where you'll be able to do all the normal stuff that you're used to. So full source control, you could pull from repositories, you can clone existing repositories, and you'll be able to do all of that stuff within this IDE. But for this demo, I'm going to go ahead and create a new app. I'm going to name it TechNow, because this is a TechNow demo, of course. Give it a short description here. Give it a scope name. And then it's going to bootstrap some of the app for me, including a little bit of a demo. And it's going to create some schema, some underlying files. It's going to incorporate all of the ServiceNow code that we know and love, including all the different modules that we'll need, like Glide Record and Glide System and a bunch of extra stuff. So you'll see that in my starter script that it already had given me access to business roles and client scripts. And so I'm going to write a client script right now. You'll notice that I'm running it in a different format called Fluent. It's new in this SDK V2. One of the cool things also is, because this is all inside of our environment, when I start typing, it has all the cool stuff that we know and love, like showing us exactly what is available to us. So when I typed type, it knew to give me the option of unload, and I can write my scripts directly into this. So if I hit the build button, in the background, our new Fluent way of doing things inside of the SDK will build my version of this app and then deploy it immediately. And now within the environment, without having to leave, I can actually go check out my meta records and actually see them in UI. And it goes both ways. That's right. So what I'm going to be able to do is type in this script field and then save it. And then when I go back, you'll see that it automatically updates, because we want to make sure there's one source of truth for the records and that they're always in sync. So it's a really cool way to edit our client scripts, business roles, and different, all via script, all via this new IDE that is built directly into ServiceNow. So a lot more attractive to some of us that are used to these traditional development methods. So on the next example, I'm going to create a business rule. And the thing I wanted to show you in this example is that you'll notice that I have my normal IntelliSense, but I have those red squigglies because it's telling me that I don't have enough information yet that it needs for it to successfully build a business rule. It's all built into this framework. And so you'll see that I keep having those red squigglies until I finish typing my fourth property, which is when, and I'm going to put after, and then all that squigglies go away. And so now it knows that I'm going to be able to create this business rule without causing an error. Okay, next thing I want to show is that script, I can actually go to this other file that I have, script.js, and you'll see that it already has some ServiceNow script written into it. And instead of having to put it all in this one file, I can actually call showStateUpdate from my other file, as long as I say import showStateUpdate from this other script.js file. And there you could go. Now I'll be able to even control click or command click through to find that exact function. So I'm going to go ahead and finish writing this business rule and build. And just like that client script, I'm going to go ahead and reveal it in the other window. And here's my brand new business rule that I made entirely out of script. And just like before, I can add a new change, build it again, and then if I refresh my record, we'll see that delete was added to my action. And just like we did before, I can go into my script file now, and entirely in JavaScript, in its own file, I have the script that I want to use. So I can make updates to this script.js file and build the application and see that it will automatically get pushed over to the business rule. And now I have a dedicated JavaScript file just for that script. There it is. Earl says hi. And now I will round this off and say bye, but last things I want to mention is that in this new Fluent framework, we don't just have client scripts and business rules. We are able to actually build several new things, including ACLs, lists, REST API, and even entire tables. We can build an entire table via this scripting interface. Awesome, and that's the SDK v2 and new ServiceNow IDE.